I think it all began when I was 2 or 3 years old and struck with whooping cough and convulsions.
Mm-hmm. The baby is not keeping well for quite some time. Mm-hmm. I don't know what's wrong.
Hey, doctor, can't you see? Are you blind, my son? Don't believe him. He killed my wife. Bloody butcher.
Has he been like this for quite some time now?
Yes, doctor. He has not eaten anything for 3 days now.
I just can't understand. If the well water was contaminated, you would have been ill as well. Well, what can we do? Bring these tablets now. And keep applying the cold compress. Also see that he gets some nourishment. Don't lose hope. Have faith in God, Parameshwaran. All will be well.
And so they made a vow to a god in some distant hills that my head would be shaved clean and my hair offered with due rites if my life was spared. Mother even knotted a little coin in a piece of cloth as a reminder, although no one could trace it some years later. During my growing years, however, the promise was lost sight of when the family was drawn into a prolonged legal battle over some ancestral property.
Oh yes, this is the point. I am absolutely sure that we are going to win the case now.
Whatever you do, kindly finish this case.
Don't you worry, Parameshwaran. Everything will be all right. Oh, thank you.
Hello, Mr. Parmeshwaran. How's business?
Years later, however, father, a wholesale grain merchant now, and thus lost in the maze of profits and losses, while casually turning the leaves of an old diary in his shop, discovered the record of his promise to life.
My God.
What do we do now?
Well, just cut his hair.
Yes. After all, a vow has to be fulfilled. But...
But what?
He's not a child anymore. He's a grown-up boy who goes to college.
So what? A vow is a vow.
Yes, a vow has to be fulfilled.
Your 20-year-old vow does not concern me. You had no business to pawn my scalp without consulting me.
Nitya, you were only 2 years old then.
You should have done it then. At that age, you could have handled my head as you pleased.
You were very sick, son. We had lost all hopes. God saved you.
Look, I've survived, which proves that the disease died rather than me. So where is God's hand in all this? That is, if there is a God and if he's interested in my hair.
Nitya, you must not be blasphemous.
Whatever you do, don't talk like that.
If God had not responded to our prayers and saved your life, you would not have been dead.
Was it a bargain?
Yes. It was indeed a bargain. There can be no going back on it.
But, very well. But the head offered for a shave was not yours. You have been carrying on negotiations with a commodity that did not belong to you.
Nitya, it's for your welfare.
Did I ask for it?
Nitya.
You talk like a sinner, cold and heartless. I wonder where you inherited it from.
Father, please try to understand me. I'll be the laughing stock of my...
Not a word more. We are leaving by the morning bus on Friday.
Hello, Nitya. How are you? Why are you looking so fancy, huh? Something the matter, Nitya?
Oh, no. How are you, sir?
Oh, the same since my wife died 22 years ago. Others are 2 and 3. Selfish bastards. I am wifeless.
Is it true what the others say? What? That you mistook the kitchen for the toilet and that's why your wife deserted you?
Nonsense. I have jealous neighbors. It's not my mistake if the kitchen looks like a toilet. Listen to this engineer's advice. Never get married. Marriage ruins people.
I don't need to get married. My parents are already ruining my life.
Parents? How?
They're threatening to shave my hair off.
Shave your hair off?
Mm.
How dare he? Paresh Maran!
Sir, it's all right.
Oh,
my
Paresh Maran!
Sir!
Mr. Parmeshwaran? Ah, there you are. I was about to go to your house. The lawyer, you know, on the opposite side, has maneuvered yet another postponement on your case.
That is what you have been doing all these 18 years. Look, I'm not Kubera, the god of wealth.
Of course.
You have dwindled most of my family assets in this court case.
Don't worry, sir. We will fight it to the very end. And he, your son, will be the sole heir to the whole property.
Leave my hair alone and then fight as you please.
What did you say?
Nothing. There comes the bus. What sort of a journey is this?
You must learn to be patient, my boy. Ours is a poor country. We cannot afford the luxuries they have in Madras or Bombay.
The bus rocks and sways and sighs with its burden, but won't burst yet. Perhaps the last straw is still to arrive. But the real question is, who owns this? Not the driver, surely, who displays immense self-assurance and drives his bus with reckless gusto, tossing and jolting passengers up and down, though no one seems to mind. And definitely not the conductor, though he grows heavier every minute, with the coins dropping like manna into his pocket.
You must walk from here.
Yes, I know.
When will the bus come back?
5, 6, 7:30 tomorrow.
Right, right.
Seems to be perched on a hillock across the horizon. It is impossible to judge the distance. A track formed by the tread of feet meanders through the fields. And afraid I might run away, my parents are trying to sandwich me. But what chance have I, wrapped by slush and vegetation on both sides of this narrow path?
Haven't we? Go ahead with your tonsure.
This is not the temple, son. Only the archway. The temple is a long way off.
Don't you remember the story of Hanuman fighting Garuda?
Fighting? Here too.
Come on, come on. How could he remember when we last brought him here? He was hardly thinking.
Mm-hmm. Of course.
Why come so far if God is everywhere? I could as well have surrendered my head to our Vinayak Street barber, who even shaves you at your own doorstep.
Nitya, we have not come here for nothing. This temple was established by our ancestors 500 years ago. It was on this very hill that Kumara annihilated the demon.
Yes, yes. What demon was it?
His name...
A demon is a demon, whatever its name.
Oh, yes. In fact, this temple was built by a Chola king, who in course of time turned it over to our ancestors.
How can you be so sure?
You have got into the habit of questioning everything.
I just wanted to know, that's all.
Well and wise man, there's a document at the temple, a palm leaf. My great-grandfather's name is mentioned in it. It is this that will clean the issue in our favor at the appellate stage.
Even at this distance and on a consecrated spot, my father is unable to keep his mind off the appellate stage and the civil court. Very much like the engineer of his wifelessness.
Rama! Manjunda! Where is everybody?
Dude, sir! Hey, let Rishi has come. Hema, get some milk, bananas, umbrella. Oh my God, umbrella. Fast, chair, fast. Please come, sir. Please come inside, sir.
Yes, later. First to the temple.
This way, sir. This way, please. Please come, sir.
Where is the headman?
They are all away in the fields for weeding, sir. They will be back soon, sir. Chair. Sir, please be seated. Please be seated.
Send someone to fetch him.
Sure, sir. Sure. Hey, go and get the headman. Hey, the umbrella, you fool.
Just what I needed.
Nitya, not now. After the vow.
The bananas wilt in the tray and the milk curdles irreparably. But not now, after the vow, says God, through my father, in a perfect rhyme.
Good afternoon, sir. Sorry for the delay. I was supervising the weeding in the field.
You show me your face once a year. That too for the collection of 20 measures of rice and 200 rupees. Is this how you carry out your responsibilities?
I am sorry, sir. I have not been keeping well of late. Here is the receipt for December's contribution.
Where is the priest? Get the temple opened. We have to get back to Malgudi by the evening bus.
Must you? You can spend the night here, sir.
You may both stay back if you choose. But I want to catch the bus. There's a students' union meeting this evening.
Vitya, be patient. What could be more important than your duty to God?
Yes. Here you are. How are your drinking habits these days?
The well at the temple needs to be deepened. And this lock needs to be replaced. You come once in a blue moon and you ask me all sorts of questions. Mr. Trustee, do you know that it is very difficult to get flowers and supplies from the village these days? They are not only irregular, but they raise the rates each time.
All right. We will see to it later, after the ceremony. Now go and make preparations for the puja. Why are you sitting down again?
I'm too tired.
Will someone go and get the barber?
Yes, sir.
My son's tonsure, whatever happens.
Yes, sir. Umbrella. Hey, don't bite your nails. Go to the tank bund and bring the barber immediately with his razor box. Go, run.
Come on, get up. We must not be late for puja.
I have finished bathing the god. You can seek his blessings now.
Om Evam Sadayo Kaya Asam Adipad Eta Pachavan Yatam Pechan Yoga Vishavam Om Pihuan Vat Vyave Sadano Yehwan Sadayo Kaya Pachavan Pechan Yoga Vishavam Eta Pachavan Even the oil is adulterated nowadays.
After the tonsure. After the tonsure.
All right.
Are the ceremonies over?
No. This is the pre-tonsure ceremony. Two more ceremonies to go.
Trustee, sir. Trustee, sir. The barber's house is locked. Not a soul there.
Is yours the neighbor?
They don't know, sir. They only saw the family board the bus with some luggage, sir.
God is great, really.
Cheh, this is the worst of it. Having only one barber in the entire place. As the saying goes, the one and only Padmavati for the whole town.
Ajula, he's talking about Padmavati here. Who is Padmavati?
Don't you know? Padmavati is a reference to a whore.
Oh God, what awful words to utter in this place.
Padma, Barbar.
Poor Raghavan cannot make both ends meet unless he plays the pipe at the wedding ceremonies. It's their family tradition, sir. Go and search for Raghavan, you fool.
I can't understand how these barbers can be custodians of our classical music.
Yes, sir. For ages now.
The second ceremony is now over. Raghavan has not come, isn't it, sir? I knew it. Panthers, tiger. Sir, why don't you listen to a piece of advice? Nowadays, tonsure is not possible unless it is done in childhood. Young people do not allow the barber to come anywhere near them, sir. Therefore, the vow is taken sometimes to be fulfilled to a token performance. Only a token performance, mind you.
Well spoken, sir, well spoken. Get me a pair of scissors and I will give you some hair off my forelock, the best available. God will also be satisfied. After all, with so many offerings, where can he keep his collections? Isn't it, sir?
Yes, but the penalty will be more.
Doesn't matter, sir, doesn't matter.
You give 50 rupees.
Raghavan has come, Raghavan has come.
Oh, God, no.
He is Raghavan, the barber, sir. He is such a religious person. He never performs a tonsure ceremony without first having a bath, sir.
Forgive me, sir. I had been to the neighboring village for a baby's tonsure.
Not to play the pipe at someone's wedding?
Oh, no, sir. I have jealous neighbors who create false rumors to spoil my business. If I had known the trustee was coming, I would not have gone, even for 1,000 pieces of gold. As soon as the boy came and told me, I left whatever I was doing and came running here, sir. Sir, I am ready now, sir.
Nitya, let us sit there and finish the rancher. Come on.
No. I agreed to give you the forelock of my hair. It was up to you to have taken it. Now you've lost the opportunity.
Nitya, now with this man here, we must fulfill the vow as originally promised.
Let father use the barber if he likes. I'm not interested.
Nitya, Nitya, you must not hurt your parents.
Hey, you mind your own business.
Nitya, for heaven's sake, don't get kabarakas. Come on.
Have you no logic or reason? No contentment or consistency? How can God tolerate fickle-minded people like you?
Nitya.
Listen carefully. I won't give even an inch of my hair.
Nitya, for God's sake, the barber is ready.
But my head is not ready. I will wait for you at the bus stand, but only till the bus arrives.
The story of my tonsure ended thus. God is great.